Geico asks, how would you love a chance to save some money on insurance? Of course you would. And when it comes to great rates on insurance, Geico can help. Like with insurance for your car, truck, motorcycle, boat, and RV. Even help with homeowners or renters coverage. Plus, add an easy-to-use mobile app, available 24-hour roadside assistance, and more, and Geico is an easy choice. Switch today and see all the ways you could save. It's easy. Simply go to geico.com or contact your local agent today.
Everyone is talking about Top Gun Maverick, and it's now the number one movie in the world.
Outstanding!
It will leave you cheering.
Yes!
And is the ultimate summer movie experience.
Damn right.
Tom Cruise, Top Gun Maverick, rated PG-13.
Hey, Ola, it's Miles. Thank you guys for listening to the Men's Room Daily Podcast.
Have you heard our newest podcast? It's called The Greatest Story Never Told.
Download it today on radio.com. Be sure to subscribe. New episodes are uploaded every Tuesday at noon.
The debauchery rolls on. You're listening to The Men's Room with Miles and Thrill. 99.9 KISW.
Our question, who or what was responsible for the damage done? And here come those emails from The Men's Room at KISW.com.
You've got mail.
Coming from today's question, guys, I was up in Alaska working last year, about to come back down here, when I get a call from my roommate. He says, I hate to tell you this, being as tomorrow is your birthday, but you better call Allstate. My first thought was that he wrecked my Mustang. I asked him to drive a little bit while I was gone, so I wasn't just sitting around. Oh, no, not that mundane. Some jackass with a medical issue drove through our yard. He hit my buddy's Toyota, tore the right front tire and axle arm off of it, knocked that into the BMW so hard it bent the frame. Then he T-boned my Mustang, sitting in the driveway, spun it 90 degrees around the neighbor's Jeep and ricocheted back out on the street, and then drove home. Luckily, a guy driving past saw the whole thing and followed him home before coming back to get the cops. And, of course, no license, no insurance. Flew down a week later and had to ride my Harley down to Portland for work while my girlfriend followed in her car with all the stuff.
I like when someone says, hey, yeah, man, you just reach out to Allstate.
Guys, during elk season in Wyoming, after 3 days of hunting, we went back to camp. Next morning, we got up, loaded up our rifles. Weather got really bad, so we decided to stay at the camp. I unloaded my rifle. Excuse me. Being that I'm left-handed, I accidentally opened the bolt, and its shell went into the chamber, and I close the bolt, and I hit it with my right hand. The rifle goes off. Right through the passenger side door with the window rolled up and shattered the window, left a one-inch hole on the outside of the door. I guess I'm the only guy that went elk hunting because I shot a ram. Because I had a Dodge Ram pickup truck.
Yeah, I see what you did there.
That from the Elk Plain Drifter. I was driving out of here like last Monday. So when you leave, you have to use a key card.
Yeah.
So I was rolling down my window. I reach my hand out, and I use the key card. Then I drive up the ramp, and I roll my window up so I can see out. You know, they see no cars coming to the left. Of course, I didn't realize I rolled my window up. So I go, oh, hit the inside of my window with a super huge Luke, right? I have no napkins.
Right.
I have nothing to clean this up. It just had to sit there and kind of drip down my window the whole way home. I'm looking at it like.
Did you try opening the window and then?
No, I didn't want to make any more of a mess. It's just like, ah.
That's gross, man.
Damn. Thank you.
And it's right next to your head.
Yeah. All right, let's move on to the birthday emails,
so
guys.
Maybe don't spit inside a garage.
Yeah. I was out. I was already on the street.
Mm-hmm. Just in your car.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Hey, all, my husband's birthday was on November 12th, and I really effed up and forgot to send my email. Can you please get a birthday shout-out on your next show? Nope. We don't do that, Heather.
You did really F up.
Yeah. Guys, I want to pass along a big birthday boo bitch to my grandson on his 22nd trip around the big yellow ball. He's in the National Guard. So how about some turtle wax whether your penis is too small and a suck it up cupcake in the paws. Thanks, guys. That from Thomas.
You know, Ted, you ruined me on that your penis is too small quote. When we first started playing that, you said, you know, if you didn't know, she could be saying, your penis is too swole.
So swole!
That's too big for me. That's a compliment.
Too swole!
Captain Swole.
Guys, please give a birthday shout out to my little sister, Christine, who moved to Italy and still listens to you guys every day.
Mom,
she has a dirty mind, loves your show, and would love the dirty Germans to give her a happy birthday, talking about their usual sexual innuendos. Thanks, guys. We love you. Appreciate the shout out.
Yeah, it's not much of a trip from Deutschland to Italy. So remember one thing.
The Italians are all about the sexual innuendo. Everywhere you go, you will see a red pepper. That is in place of a penis. True.
Yes, the main thing is, I hope these Italians wear their fancy boots. It's a country, it's shaped like a boot.
Oh, yes. Kicking a rock, yes.
Yeah, high heel boots.
Yeah, what is that poor island? Leave it alone. You've been kicking it for centuries.
Yeah, they send us a message. We wear high heel boots in bed.
Guys, can you please give my son Parker J.
It's like I'm running the crane.
Please give my son Parker J. a very happy birthday. I love you the most, Peanut. Having a barbershop face sandwich. That from the mom, Crystal.
Can I get a fish sandwich? Oh, you know I gotta eat right. Oh, brother, can I have a fish sandwich? She put the cheese and the tartar on the side.
Hello, gentlemen. Today's my sister-in-law Devin's 21st birthday. Was wondering if the dirty Germans would wish her a happy birthday. Stay safe and healthy. Thanks. That from her brother, Mark.
Yeah, if you turn 21, this is the time to experiment with the 21 position. You go on your knees, have your back to me, and I stand up straight.
Yeah, said if it's a 21st birthday, she's already used to drinking bad things and swallowing it, so it should be a fun night.
Yeah, they call me Fireball because it stings.
Yeah, what, you got one of those shots out of the plastic cups?
I was trying to show Miles the 21 position, man.
Yeah.
So you're down on your knees, right? Uh-huh. Then they kind of crawl around and lean forward. Mm-hmm. And I just stand up straight behind you.
Sure.
See?
Why not?
Go.
But y'all has been listening for much of this year when I was introduced to you guys via friend. Could you please give me a big old bong rip, followed by some turtle wax to celebrate during the double year of horror? Thanks, guys. That from Natasha. Is my girlfriend Cynthia. Oh, sorry, Cynthia.
You always talk before people finish.
Girlfriend Cynthia is turning the corner of a century today. On the weekends, we listen to you guys and talk about our own stories of certain topics on Big Dummy. She would love to hear some thrill gets along with Coach Ted coaching her on what to do since she is now 25. Thank you, gents, and thanks for keeping our sanity in check. Peace and love. That from Brett.
Get. Yeah. 25.
You know, 25 is a good birthday. Number one, you're a little bit older. But number two is, you're not 30 yet. You're 25. It's a big, momentous one. People will buy you cocktails. Maybe they won't. But either way, enjoy it, celebrate it.
Yeah.
You're still in your 20s. Go make some mistakes.
Hola, Men's Room crew. Today is my 33rd birthday. I'm hoping you can play a Suck It Up cupcake, have some dirty Germans do their thing. My new hubby Jeff and I got married October 30th, so today is my first birthday as a wifey. Big healthy hugs to each of you and your production crew. Your daily show brightens my spirit. Thanks, guys. That from the lovely Danielle.
So, suck it up, cupcake!
Yeah, today you turn 33, like the 12-inch vinyl. That's good. I like 33 RPM. Which is ripe penis massage.
Yes, you know, when I see the Cersei Sea, I just think of that classic green bottle from La Trobe.
Yeah, La Trobe sounds like a part of the body you find on the inside.
So be Abby's a rolling rock.
I'm going to put my finger on your La Trobe.
Can you imagine getting that for your 33rd birthday?
I'd be so pissed.
Oh, God.
I don't mind rolling rock.
I know you don't mind rolling rock. It's just designed to make you belch.
Guys, I'm turning 35 today, and I can't stand the barbershop quartet. All I want is the quartet to start and then get cut off immediately with a cut that bitch off. Thanks, guys. That from Vincenzo.
Is it too
late? Cut that bitch off! Next caller.
Pachola, okay. Here you go. Can I order up a barbershop fish sandwich for my husband, Matt? It's the 35th anniversary of his first birthday. And we're celebrating the birth of our first child. Thanks, guys. That from Yvonne.
Is it too early for a fish sandwich? Cheese and tartar on the side.
Oh, yeah.
I smell a fish sandwich, maybe some dill relish in the morning, at noon, and at night, and at night.
We got one that came over the comments here. It says, I've been listening to The Rock since 1979 and never knew I should email in the birthday request. I added that part. Mm-hmm. Today is my 55th trip around the sun. Can I get a shout out and an owl hitting the glass? That from Shannon in Snohomish.
Guys, birthday shout out to my husband, Eric. He's 35 today, a huge Men's Room fan, never misses a podcast or radio.com. He's my rock and my best friend. He keeps me laughing, spoils me rotten, and definitely doesn't hurt that he is hung like a moose.
Please
give him him a Homer Simpson fish sandwich and have Coach Ted get him in line and ready for what I plan to do to him and his Excalibur tonight. Thanks, guys. Ad from Kerry.
Fish sandwich. Are you sure?
What's this guy's name?
Moose, apparently.
Or King Arthur.
All right, Moose. I'll tell you what. Starting right now, we got to hydrate. I mean, good Lord. Walking around there with that thing, just swinging in it left and right. The wife is fired up. I don't know where she plans on putting it, but it's going to get done. Hydrate, man. Sounds like this woman's going to try to hurt you.
Yeah, she's going to work it like a fire pole slide all the way down.
Yeah.
A little bit jealous. My brain dead stepdad isn't too tech savvy, so he wanted me to write my birthday shout out from him. Not many people do that, so we'll see how this one goes. He says, happy birthday to Carrie from Braindead. Please give her a fish sandwich and a suck it up cupcake and the dirty German saying how it is to be 47. Rock on, guys. That from Carrie.
Can I buy you a fish sandwich?
So suck it up, cupcake!
Yeah, I know what it is like to be 47. It is a special treat that we have. We call it the condiment. Tonight we will teach you the Heinz 47 maneuver.
Yeah, that one involves a lot of licking.
Yeah, and starting from behind.
Yeah, you always have to use one finger to taste it first.
Yeah, in anticipation. Twizzlers comes out slowly. But if you shake it, eventually it will happen.
Yeah, in 10 more years you can have the 57.
Yeah, special sauce.
Guys, requesting a birthday shout-out for Wayne Dew. On his 50th birthday, he would love a Suck It Up cupcake and the Dirty Germans. Thank you, guys. Appreciate it.
So, suck it up, cupcake!
Yeah, when I look down at a certain part of my anatomy tonight, I expect to quote your name.
Yeah, this guy seems very interesting. He just goes by Wayne Dew.
Yeah, what is that on you? Oh, that's Wayne Dew.
Yeah, I woke up in the morning, and I could see also Wayne Dew on the grass.
That's Wayne Dew on my bed sheets.
Yeah, it's damp out here.
It's from Wayne.
It smells funky. It's Wayne Dew.
Yeah. That sounds like a really bad martial art. Back up, I know Wayne Dew.
All right, guys, here we go.
Happy, happy, happy birthday. Happy, happy, happy birthday. Happy, happy, happy birthday to you.
Yaws of Dirty Germans, brought to you by Men's Room Original Sausage. Available through Uli's World Famous Sausage, mensroomlive.com, and other fine retailers. Schweinefleisch.
Yes, friends, it's time once again for Sit and Spin. Let's gather around the old radio and listen to some swellerific new music.
Oh,
look. What's happening?
We're all dressed up today. Ryan Castle joining us from his basement. We can see him. The good news is he doesn't have to look at us.
I was businessing today, so I put most of my clothes on, but not all of them.
So are you even wearing pants? We can only see that you have a button up. I mean, you look snazzy, but there's no reason for you to be wearing pants.
I am wearing one dress sock.
That is okay. How's life treating you there at the home front? Everything good?
Yeah.
Dogs
yeah,
are cool.
You know, it's nice being home. All the time, every day.
Yeah. Today on Sit and Spin, you have the 10 greatest boy band songs of all time. So I want to say this list.
Yeah.
It didn't come from Rolling Stone magazine. Is that where it came from?
Yeah, it did. And you know, a lot of people think of boy bands, and it might be our age. You think of all of the stuff that happened in the late 90s, perhaps with the NSYNCs and the Backstreet Boys
or
and stuff like that.
But
The boy band goes back as far as music itself. I mean, when Bigo and Og would grunt in unison and choreograph rock banging in the caves, the cave girls would swoon. I mean, boy bands have been around forever, and we dip into all of it. And, you know, there's and you might even be able to make an argument for some of these not being boy bands, and I think there are some that you might think should have been on the list because you qualify them as boy bands that maybe Rolling Stone didn't.
It seems like one of the arguments people have about defining a boy band, you know, you can look at NSYNC and we go like, right, that's a boy band. But
sure,
some people argue the Beatles, and I would argue the Beatles were a boy band, at least to start, right? But people have
they were a teen sensation.
Right.
No question.
Definitely a teen sensation. But if you write your own music and play your own instrument, somehow you don't get classified as that. But if you were singing other people's music or songwriters written for you and you don't play instruments, then you become a boy band.
So then where the monkeys fall on that? Because they at first did not play their own instruments, but later started to play their own instruments.
See, I would argue that they were a boy band. They were put together for the distinct purpose of like you said, swooning the cave ladies back in the time.
They were a manufactured band.
Absolutely. I think of most of these, but in my mind, I want to say they're all hairless. You know what I'm saying at that point?
I try not to go down that road myself.
I think that's the one thing that they all have in common.
They're all twinks, yeah.
Exactly. So these are the 10 greatest boy band songs of all time on Sit and Spin.
10, number 10. New kids on the block, had a bunch of hands. Chinese food makes me sick. And I think it's fly away.
Great song.
For the summer.
I was just thinking the opposite of that, Ted.
Who is that, LFO?
That's LFO, and I was just thinking, like, how... Oh, that's... When I saw them on the list, I was like, I don't know if I know that song, and then as soon as it started, I was like, oh, yeah, it's that dumb song.
Yeah, what's it like? Oh, that's got to be, like, 2000, 2001?
He gets sick when he eats Chinese food?
The song is Summer Girls.
Summer Girls.
What's wrong with Chinese food?
Makes him sick, dude.
Okay, all right, didn't know.
Actually, that song actually meant Some Our Girls. I went to a brothel, he was pointing out.
Oh, got it.
10
Honestly,
greatest...
it's not been to Ballard Mandarin, because that's the spot.
That is. 10 greatest boy band songs of all time.
Number 9.
There you go, Miles.
Oh, yeah.
All right, so how's this fall into your classification of a boy band, though? Because these kids played their own instruments and wrote their own songs.
For whatever reason, and look, I mean, like I said, it's a real malleable definition. In my mind, they're not a boy band, even though Hanson, in every capacity, is a boy band. But I just don't regard them that way. Mm-hmm.
I don't either. And I like boy bands. But they're playing instruments and writing the music. I think what you said earlier about the beat, like, you could be a teen band.
All right, so teen sensation made up of boys... in a band, but you are not a boy band.
Correct.
Okay.
Hanson's all that more. These are the 10 greatest boy band songs of all time.
Number 8.
You're welcome for having this stuck in your head for the rest of the day, too, for sure.
This is their biggest song, right?
It is like herpes on your brain. You cannot get rid of it.
I'm sure they're still closing the show with this one, correct?
You would think. I mean, I don't know. You went to the last New Kids on the Block show. You tell me.
I went to the last 3 before the tour got shut down.
Did you go to 3 of
no.
these?
No.
Oh.
But it sounded cool if I did, didn't it? Yeah. These are the 10 greatest boy band songs of all time. So many thirsty older women then.
They're not older to us anymore. What in the blue hell is this?
Who is this?
Is that Menudo?
It's going to come as a shock to you, but I also was not familiar with this. The band is called Aventura, and the song came out in 2002. It's called Obsession.
Is this one of those, like, even the Rolling Stones go deep? Rolling Stone magazine even goes deep on boy bands. Like, yeah, we know, I mean, cooler boy bands than you do. Stone,
you're so damn pretentious. You could have put Menudo on the list, but no. We have to go with Aventura.
See, that's the Rolling Stone way. I couldn't tell you a song from Menudo, but I've heard of Menudo because that's a band that never disappears.
Ricky Martin was in Menudo.
Right. Oh, that's right.
Well, there were 100 members in Menudo. I think the guys in Gojira were in Menudo at one point.
Everybody's been in that. Right?
These are the 10 greatest boy band songs of all time.
Number 6. Baby, you light up my world like nobody else. The way that you lift your head gets me overwhelmed. But when you smile at me,
who is this?
I don't know. That's, hang on. That's what?
Is it One Direction?
Yeah, it's 1D. Okay.
1D.
You act like
1D. 1D.
It's like 560. You light a candle to mark the anniversary of them breaking up every year.
Oh, yeah. I do. And I changed the smell of the candle.
But now wait, they write at least half of their own music and 2 of them play instruments? Right, so there's the one dude that sings. My guess is he can't play anything. Then you have the drummer kid and the really crappy guitar player. But at least they're playing.
Well, at least the guy had a sense of humor and called himself Harry Styles. That is funny.
I do appreciate it.
Yeah, that's very cool.
But
Harry
Styles
is a legend.
Yeah.
Do they qualify as a boy band?
I can't remember.
Yeah, 2/3 are playing instruments, though.
One Direction is a boy band.
Yeah, I feel like they were like, we're a boy band. I mean, right? And then when they only made it to like their mid-20s and they all took off.
Sure.
10 greatest boy band songs of all times on Sit and Spin.
Number 5.
Oh, is this K-pop?
Yeah, now, I know Mike Hawk is into K-pop, but for the rest of you, this is K-pop sensation BTS. This song came out this year. It's called Moon.
So wait, is K-pop a band or is K-pop a style?
K-pop is Korean pop music.
Yeah, it's like a genre.
Okay.
And they just like pump them out and people love it.
See, that's the thing. I'm always, they're always talking about K-pop. And I'm like, is this a band or what the hell is it?
Probably have more downloads and more sales than any other genre, any other, in the world. Wouldn't you think for the last year or so?
It's huge. Yeah. It's massive.
These are the 10 greatest boy band songs of all time.
Number 4.
There you go.
I know the song, but I don't know what band it is.
Is this NSYNC?
Oh. Backstreet Boys?
Yes.
Silly Miles Montgomery.
I get so confused.
Millennium is a just solid album.
Top to bottom.
I remember when this album came out, they set a record for most album sales in a single day when this thing came out. I don't remember what it was, but it was like 1.5 million or something crazy like that on the very first day. Most bands don't sell that in their careers now, but no. They did it in a day when this album came out.
I used to have to play this song at least twice an hour, every hour, when I first got in radio on WLIF. And I had no problem telling people, this song sucks, but you love it. Here it is.
10 greatest boy band songs
of all time. Number three.
Oh, yeah. Now we're talking.
Gaz, what's the tune that you argue is the single greatest pop song ever in? Is it this one?
No, we haven't gotten to that one yet, but it is on the list.
Now, is there any way in hell that you could do some kind of tuning with a microphone where Bobby Brown, what was he, 8 years old, 9 years old when he sang that song? Could he sing that song now? I mean, listen to this.
No.
Could he ever do that? What would you have to do? You have to run him through some kind of, I don't know, compressor or something, just take all the lows out.
No, you put a hot soldering iron in his record. I mean, it's the only way.
Or you just play it in a lower key. You could do that, too. Mm-hmm.
These are the 10 greatest boy band songs of all time.
Here we go. Number three.
I remember playing this too. Who the hell is it?
Who is that? Is that NSYNC?
That's NSYNC.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. What number are we on now?
Did dance in the studio.
We're on number
like
one.
I
missed that one.
Mike and I did.
Very good. All right. Here we go. Any guesses on the number one boy band?
I already know what it is based on the song that I know. The castle has argued since I've known him. He just says, "Look,
Jackson 5."
When it comes to pop music, this is, you said, the most well written. I guess
it is the perfect pop song.
But Ryan did not come up with this list.
No. Yeah.
No, I did
but
not.
So but he said it has not made it.
So they agree with you. Okay.
Apparently.
This is the
perfect pop song.
Number one.
I could listen to this song over and over for the rest of my life every single day. It is that good.
It is that good.
I will tell you this. Somebody chimed in. I appreciate it. It says, "Hey, you guys are making me regret having the top off my Jeep right now, slinking down when I stop at lights."
It's okay. We've all been
You're
there.
Welcome.
Thank you, Ryan Castle. We appreciate it. There you go. On Sin Spin, you are listening to The Men's Room.
Geico asks, how would you love a chance to save some money on insurance? Of course you would. And when it comes to great rates on insurance, Geico can help. Like with insurance for your car, truck, motorcycle, boat, and RV. Even help with homeowners' or renters' coverage. Plus, add an easy-to-use mobile app, available 24-hour roadside assistance, and more, and GEICO is an easy choice. Switch today and see all the ways you could save. It's easy. Simply go to GEICO.com or contact your local agent today.
Take the next step toward the career you want, be it business, cybersecurity, healthcare, or more. UMGC can help you get there. No application fee when you apply by August 31st. Visit umgc.edu, certified to operate by Chev.
There's a new and different way to fund your business or side hustle without the hassles of a loan. HomeTap. HomeTap is an investor that gives you access to your home equity in cash in exchange for a share of your home's future value with no monthly payments or interest. How you use the money is totally up to you. HomeTap. Get more from home ownership. Get more from life. Subject to eligibility, terms and conditions apply. Visit HomeTap.com to apply in minutes. That's HomeTap.com. HomeTap.com.
The Men's Room is in progress. 99.9 KISW and KISW HD1 Seattle.
Coming up in just minutes, we will drink and toast with a shot of the day. And we do have your headlines on the way 1 hour from now. But first, quick check-in with Mike Hawk and some of the stories and headlines he is not working on.
All right, a new study found that people that play the video game Animal Crossing for 4 hours a day, every day, were happier than people that didn't.
Yeah, because they're spending 4 hours doing something they enjoy.
Correct. That's exactly right.
People that get four-hour massages more relaxed than people who don't.
Exactly. People that had 4 hours to donate to a game that they enjoy doing.
To do anything.
Yeah, right. Exactly. You know? Are happier.
I jumped up and down for 4 hours. I feel great.
That's what I wanted to do.
Yeah. I had time to do it.
How much money do you think they got for that study?
Too much.
Right. Well, we got to study this before we can say this is the fact. So we need a cool $2 million. Hey, turns out, yeah, that Animal Crossing is onto something. People like playing it.
Is that the way that you get money?
Why do you play it? Because it makes me feel happy.
Because it stresses me out and I hate my life.
Yeah.
Right. Is that all I have to do is just hypothesize about something? Yes. I wonder if people end up happier. I need money.
You play Animal Crossing, Mike?
The lady did for a little while. All right. No, I do not.
All right.
No, I do not.
I know the name. I know nothing about it.
Yeah.
Neither do I.
But you know the name, right?
Sure.
Basically, I've heard it's very popular. I wonder if it's like real life.
No.
Like deer crossing 2 miles. Like at the end of it, I don't have to worry about deer anymore, right?
You basically create just this little town.
Okay.
Plant stuff, harvest it, and you
God,
just build.
I hate stuff like that.
You
yeah.
Just, you remember The fun. Sims where you just basically took care of these people that couldn't do anything without you?
Again, I never played it. I was aware of it. It's like my kids playing Minecraft. I'm like, there's no point. You just make stuff.
Correct.
It's like having a big Lego set, but you're not trying to make anything.
It's like being alive.
Yeah. Right.
And by the way, if you don't put pieces in this Lego set every day in this exact location, then the entire thing comes down.
Yeah, it looks so boring.
Is it really about animals, or do I got to protect a weird little family?
No, there's animals in this town. The characters are just animals. They're just, it's basically one big Disney movie.
All right.
Mm-hmm. See how I am?
I'm going to play this game.
I'm
get all the animals across town.
I'll catch you in 2 hours when you're done. A couple in New York had identical triplets. All three kids born at the same time look at the exact same way.
That's weird?
Yeah, it's fairly rare.
Okay.
Is it?
Is triplets weird or rare, or is it rare that they're all identical?
I think it's both, but more that they're all identical.
Right.
Hmm.
Huh.
So, severely so that they're identical triplets.
That
triplets
would aren't exactly. Suck.
Yes!
Like, dude, I don't know who I'm mad at.
Not for them.
Three boys, three girls?
Think of the fun they can have.
I'm not working on it.
Oh, they can.
Oh, there's so much fun to be had.
Right.
Their life's just beginning.
Here's the thing. I'm at a stage in my life where I'm considering, you know, like, maybe dad would be kind of cool.
Yeah.
The thing is that I'm already terrified at taking that leap. If I somehow find out that, oh, by the way, it's not one, it's not two, it's three, I'm losing it.
No, it's simple, man. Look, somebody has a dog. The dog has puppies. They have a litter, right?
Correct.
And they give them away free to a good home. You have more than two at once. Like, look, one of them.
This is a litter.
Yeah, if that's a litter, you can legally give one away.
You don't like you.
That's what a friend told me. I'm pretty sure.
You have to have sex with that.
That's fair.
Yeah.
I said I was thinking about it.
Okay.
I will say.
I think about sex all the time.
I had a buddy that had twins. And when they found out, he was super scared. But as the kids got older, he was like, it's super easy. They just play with each other. And they're exact same age. They want to do everything
together.
Oh,
he does have an out. Yeah.
Yeah.
Buy the same clothes.
Right. He was like, dude, he's like, it's pretty simple. Like, I don't have it nearly as hard as many parents.
Did he give them rhyming names? Because when you do the rhyming name, that tells me you thought of one.
Yeah.
Right? Well, we were going to name our kid Larry. That's why we have Gary and Terry. So, look, Gary and Terry, only one of the three of you had the name the parents wanted. The other ones rhyme.
Like, anything in your parents' life, or your life if you're a parent, you only know what you know. So if you get twins, you don't know any different.
Sure.
You don't know what having one kid's like.
Well, no, wait. If you've had a kid, you know what it's like. Then if you have twins following that, that's when you're free to cry.
Oh, yeah.
60% of Americans are worried about porch pirates stealing their packages during the holidays. Well, this study again.
That means you have a porch. I hope they did not spend any money to study that.
Right. Exactly.
I'm worried about porch pirates, and I'm having fun playing this video game.
We're learning
about America.
People don't want to spend money to have something stolen, but they do like to play games.
Right.
Huh.
Interesting. An ancient Greek statue was found while crews in Athens were doing sewage work. The statue dates back to 300 BC.
I wonder who that honor fell to.
Yes.
Put in the sewer.
Yeah, right.
Off with his head.
I wonder if they hated that guy.
I don't know. I mean, seriously, like, wow, you were not very popular.
Seagulls can plan out the timing of kids' lunch breaks at school, and they swoop down to grab food.
That doesn't shock me.
No, they're way too smart for their own good.
The reason I think it's funny is because it's happening in England.
Well, crows do it here.
They do.
Yeah, but crows, for the most part, it's more, at least my interaction with crows, they won't steal it out of your hand. But they know if you're sloppy or not. Like, look, man, he never puts his lid on all the way or whatever. So, like, we'll go into your trash, much like a raccoon. But these gulls are straight up like, as soon as you open that bag, Jack, I'm snatching that sandwich.
And seagulls are big.
They're so much bigger than you think they are.
Right. I walked through a group of pigeons and seagulls the other day, and I was like, you know what? I'm across the street. A lot of seagulls.
A recent poll asked 2,000 people to rank the rudest bathroom habits, and I have the top 10 for you here. So what are the rudest bathroom habits that you guys can think of that you might know?
Not flushing the toilet.
Yeah, not flushing.
Okay.
That's a big one.
Ted?
No courtesy flush?
No courtesy flush. All right. Let's go down the list here. These are the rudest bathroom habits. Number 10, hanging toilet paper the, quote, wrong way.
I mean, hang it up. I don't care. I just want to wipe my ass.
Right. For me, it's when they actually put the new roll on top of the old roll that's still on there.
Yeah.
Pisses me out.
I don't care.
I know you don't.
Right? Well, I mean, I change it, but like, I don't know. Would you be offended if you came to my house and I had one sitting on top of the other?
Nope. That is you, Ted. But if it's mine, you put that doggone thing on the roll. Number 9, not cleaning up well enough after you shave.
Sure.
That's what I'm trying to clean up.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I was trying to get the single hair off of my bar of soap this morning. Not my hair. And I cannot. It didn't even bother me. It's just one of those things. I'm in the shower. Let me get the hair off.
And they run everywhere, man.
It was like for 2 minutes trying to get this damn thing off. Like, am I obsessing?
Mm-hmm.
Can I get that shower foam?
I know, man. I'm a bar guy. I don't know.
Yeah.
I'm with him. These are the rudest bathroom habits. Number 8, leaving the toilet seat up. The classic war.
I don't care.
Neither do I.
I already know when I go in there. Dudes. I need to prepare my area to go.
Right.
So I don't just blindly like pull down my pants and sit down like, oh, what happened?
Right.
I needed someone else to take care of that aspect of it for me.
Because when I go to the bathroom, I never want to look.
Yeah. Why did you walk out of the bathroom with your pants around your ankles and your wiener out? Oh, someone else's job to do that.
Right.
Like, no, it's my job. Like, I'm the one using the bathroom.
On that token,
the whole thing is my responsibility.
I've gotten into the habit of closing the whole doggone thing when I'm done. No, just don't just put the toilet seat down. Put the lid
down.
That's
a great call. Who's going to
do that now?
Exactly.
Because we found out, 2 years ago, every time you flush, it blows all that crap like a new toothbrush. So it's not me being courteous. It's that my toothbrush is in this bathroom, and I don't want to brush my teeth with
it. And I'm worried about animals. I don't need a rat or a snake coming up out of that drain.
Yeah. Number 7, leaving the bathroom floor wet after a shower. Hell yes. My sisters used to do that. That sucked.
There's an acceptable amount of moisture that I expect to be there. Mm-hmm. I understand you may have dripped here and there, but other times it looks like you just took a bucket of water and dumped it on the floor. Or you
stepped on it. In the corners.
Only in the corners.
In the corners.
Like, do people hide in corners to dry off? Is that what we're doing now?
I don't know. They leave it all on the doggone mat.
Yes.
They come out there and they just drip dry on the frickin' mat. Thanks.
Oh, you know what? Toothpaste, dried toothpaste in the sink.
Oh, that's not bad. Okay, so these are the rudest bathroom habits. Number 6, wet towels on the floor or hanging on a doorknob.
Yeah, I mean, just pick it up.
Yes. Right, hang the doggone thing up.
They even invented these things called, I don't know, towel racks for them. I mean, they're standard in the bathroom, man.
Mm-hmm. Well, I need one for my hair, and I need one for my body.
That's all fine and dandy. Hang the doggone thing up.
I need one for my hair, and then I need one for my body.
Number 5.
Then I use yours to dry the floor.
Exactly. Number 5, making a mess in the sink.
Yeah.
Okay, back to toothpaste.
Back to the dry up
toothpaste. What are you doing in that sink, man?
Yeah, come on. Keep it PG.
I left a mess in here for you.
It's not lotion. So you're just in a bad mood. Yeah, whatever.
That's just rude.
That also just sounds bad. I left a mess in here for you.
Go see what it is.
These are the rudest bathroom habits. Number 4, leaving a nasty smell behind and doing nothing to cover it up. You know,
I mean, there's always, it depends. Look, if there's something in there to combat the stink, I will do it.
Right.
But if there's not, like, I'm not.
You
I
have
don't know
you
what to
ever,
do.
Fan? Courtesy flush.
Yep.
Mask.
Spray.
Something.
Right.
Yeah.
And I do my best, but I do have options.
Open the window if you can. Crack it.
The problem is I lay it down and it lingers, man. It hangs out for a while.
Courtesy flush.
I try that. It doesn't work, Miles.
There's still a stink.
For me, it doesn't.
But it's dissipating it.
Okay.
For some reason,
I cut through the courtesy flush.
It comes back from its
watery grave.
Yeah, I mean, there's only so much you can do. I will not go through the full store, but my son was convinced last night the dog pooped in the bedroom. It's like, what in the dog?
Moving on. Number 3, leaving hair in the shower drain.
Well, yeah.
I mean, it's in the drain.
That's just gross, yeah.
Huge guy problem.
Massive guy problem.
Yeah, I was going to say, like, what are you supposed to do? Hair falls out.
Exactly.
I've heard.
But when the water no longer goes down the drain, you go, hey, could you get that?
What I do is I collect it all and then put it on the tile wall so it looks like there's a huge spider in there. That's where I hold it.
Right. These are the rudest bathroom habits. Number 2, if necessary, not cleaning the toilet after using it.
Well, if you spill, if you dribble.
That includes peeing on the seat.
Yeah, exactly. If you dribble. Oh.
Yeah, clean up after.
If you pee on the seat, man, clean that up.
Yeah, exactly. Savages.
You can only make a mess in my seat.
That's why you have socks.
Final guesses for the number one. Any final guesses for number one of the rudest bathroom habit?
Not close to the door when they're pooping.
All right. Miles, any guesses?
Back to toothpaste.
Mr. Hill.
I'm back to not flushing.
Not replacing an empty roll.
Ah, okay.
You go ahead and take that last sheet and then not replace it. Mm. You're a monster.
Or leave that one little crappy sheet.
Right.
Man.
That ain't going to do it.
I don't know what you think I'm doing in here. I need more than that.
Jerk. An officer in the UK is under fire for not paying the full price, and you'll never guess for what.
For what?
I'll tell you all about it 1 hour from now.
Thank you, my cock. Headlines are on the way for 1 hour from now. In the meantime, let's get a contestant online for profile. This will take caller 9 at 206-421-ROCK. All right, have we made it to drinking time?
GEICO asks, how would you love a chance to save some money on insurance? Of course you would. And when it comes to great rates on insurance, GEICO can help. Like with insurance for your car, truck, motorcycle, boat, and RV. Even help with homeowners or renters coverage. Plus, add an easy-to-use mobile app, available 24-hour roadside assistance, and more, and GEICO is an easy choice. Switch today and see all the ways you could save. It's easy. Simply go to GEICO.com or contact your local agent today.
Take the next step toward the career you want, be it business, cybersecurity, healthcare, or more. UMGC can help you get there. No application fee when you apply by August 31st. Visit umgc.edu, certified to operate by CHEV.